hear somebody's getting married today.
Yeah.
Poor bastard. They should be coming. I mean, it's only down the street.
Is Jane here?
It's Friday. His wedding is tomorrow. Videotaping it. There's Orson's camera. Now I've got to go up to this fire hall to videotape what they've decorated.
Director says cut.
Right, but just act like it's, but you don't get to see what you're doing. It's a Unity campus. Did you bring me?
Oh, wait, come back.
Wait,
Ridge, come back. Miss Spears, can I have your autograph? OJ, you were framed.
Very good.
Corning, New York. Buchanan Brouhaha.
Here we are now.
Well, my drummer, or not the drummer, the bass player, he's lost his job at Corning.
Oh, great. Wow.
He's a good bass player.
Whew. We gotta get together and jam sometime.
I know another good guitar player, too.
Counting. I hear somebody's getting married today.
Yeah.
Poor bastard.
Nobody else is here. My mom's not here.
No, they're calling me and telling me I got to pick people up. I got a full house.
How the hell are you going to pick people up?
That's what I'm saying.
What are you doing? Well, what about right there is Mike.
They should be coming. I mean, it's only down the street.
Is Jane here?
Thank you all for coming, and welcome to Emmanuel Lutheran Church. Please turn off all pagers, cell phone, and audio devices, except for earphones. We want you to hear the service, okay? Thank you.
It's not too late. You can still take off.
That's what I said to her.
Everybody keeps saying that.
She's heard that more than once today.
Freedom.
Exactly.
They're ready for you now.
The grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you always.
And also with you.
The scriptures teach us that the bond and covenant of marriage is a gift of God, and holy is a mystery in which two becomes one flesh. And imagine on the union of Christ and the church, as Janis, Robbins, and Richard, James, Buchanan, give themselves each today. We surround them with our prayers to share in their joy. Richard James Buchanan, will you have Janis Robbins to be your wife, to live together in holy marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both will live? Janis Ross, will you have Richard James to be your husband, to live together in holy marriage? You love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both live. To those gathered, will all of you gathered here today by God's grace do everything in your power to uphold and care for Janis and Richard in their life together?
We will.
Thank you. Let us pray. Eternal God, our Creator and Redeemer, as you gladden the wedding at Canaan in Galilee by the presence of your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, so bring your joy to this wedding by his presence now. Look in favor upon Janis and Richard James, and grant that they, rejoicing in all your gifts, may at length celebrate the unending marriage feast with Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forevermore.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Around your neck, write them on the tablet of your heart.
Then you will win favor and a good name in the sight of God and man. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he will make your path straight. Holy wisdom, holy word.
Thanks be to God.
Okay, I'm going to read from 1 Corinthians 13.
And now I will show you the most excellent way. If I speak in the tongues of men and of the angels,
I have not love. I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal.
If I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all mysteries and all knowledge,
and if I have faith that can move mountains but have not love,
I am nothing. If I give you all the possesses to the poor and surrender my body to the flames, but have not love,
I gain nothing. Love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud.
It is not rude, it is not self-seeking, and it is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs, love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth.
It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always preserves. Love never fails, but where there are prophecies, there will be seed.
Where there are tongues, there will be still. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part.
But when perfection comes, the imperfect disappears. When I was a child, I talked like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child.
When I became a man, I put childish ways behind me. Now we see but the poor reflection as in a mirror.
Then we shall see face to face. Know I know in part, then I shall know fully, even as I am fully known.
And now these three remain, faith, hope, and love, but the greatest of these is love. Holy wisdom, holy word.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand for the reading of the gospel. The Gospel according to St. John 15. As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Continue in my love. If you keep my commandments, you shall abide in my love, even as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. These things I have spoken unto you, that my joy might remain in you, and that your joy might be full. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please be seated. Now here comes the fun part. The sermon, the homily, the message, the sermon that you probably haven't heard in years, right? You won't remember anything. Trust me, I know this. But what you will remember is seeing Jan at that door. You will remember walking. You remember lighting the unity candle. You might remember the kiss. You will remember the thoughts. You have to remember this day. Because this is the day that the Lord has made especially for you. A poem by Helen Steiner Weiss. Love is a language that every heart speaks. For love is the one thing that every heart seeks. And when there is love, God too will abide and bless the couple residing inside. That is our hope, that God will continue to bless your union. For you're already together. And the marriage is like, well, the icing on the cake. That's the good thing. I have no doubt in my heart both of you will love each other and that you want to do this. I believe this to be true. The most important thing all of your friends. Now take a look around. These are the individuals that support you because they're here. Okay, maybe not all. Maybe one or two are just quite nosy. But the truth of the matter is, most of them support you. And this is good news, because this means they came together in love, just for you. You're going to journey together. And you know, life is not going to be easy. It hasn't been easy already. But you want to make life better for each other. You want to make life better for the children and better for the family as a whole. It's going to take time. You had some time before this day to think about all this, you know? You had some time before this day to work this out. I think you've done an excellent job. As I told you when we did premarital counseling, you guys scored the highest in what it means financially responsible to each other and for each other. And that to me is remarkable. I've never had a couple to score 82% before. They normally score in the 20s. That fact alone proves that you guys have worked out a lot of kinks before you came to the altar. And this is good news. Be happy and know that God loves you both. God loves you more than you love each other. And he will be there to help you and to guide you. Amen.
Amen.
Wasn't so bad, right?
No.
Okay. Please read some more. Rings, O God. May they who wear them live in your love and in fidelity and continue in your service all the days of their life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Janice, I give you this ring. It's a sign of my love.
Richard James Buchanan and Janice Robbins, by the promises before God and in the presence of this assembly, you have bound yourself one to another as husband and wife. Those who God has joined together, let no one separate. Please join me lighting the unity candle.
Thank you.
find delight in each other, and live together in holy love until your life's end. Amen. Let us praise God for all the gifts which we rejoice today. Lord God, constant in mercy, we recall your acts of unfailing love for the human family and for all your people everywhere. We praise you for the joy which your servants, Richard and Janice, have found in each other. And we pray that you give to us such a sense of your constant love. Let us pray for Richard and Janice. Bless them in their work and in their companionship, in their sleeping and waking, in their joys and sorrows. Father, you bless the family and renew your people. Enrich all husbands and wives, all parents and children, more and more with your grace, that strengthening and supporting each other, they may serve those in need and be a sign of the fulfillment of your perfect kingdom in their parenting, their life, and in their death. Let their love for each other be a seal upon their hearts, a mantle about their shoulders, and a crown upon their forehead. Strengthen them in constant fidelity and toward each other. Sustain and defend them in the midst of trials and temptation. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Creator and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forevermore. Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray for all families throughout the world, for your Son, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit in you, dear God, live and reign forever. Lord, teach us to pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
By the power invested in me, through the ELCA and the State of New York, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Richard, you may kiss your bride.
Congratulations. You guys are too young to get married.
Start fading it out. that was this table was done by one of the founding fathers of this church here.
Go see everybody.
Hi.
Any words of wisdom, advice to the
get married
newlywed?
Quick. No. Oh, the
no,
newlywed.
No, to the newlywed. I'm
enjoy
already married.
Enjoy your honeymoon. Woo!
6-0. 6-6 burn.
She was up there like this.
Oh, did you see her arm?
Yeah.
Dan.
Right
here. Go ahead and take some. Dan.
What's up, little man? What do you think about all this wedding stuff? Don't like it?
Calm down.
Nah, we can go have some food though right now. You like food? That's my favorite dish.
Who are we gonna have that hang my
scar? Look directly up here. Up here, big smiles, we're all set. One more. Big smiles. Riley, sit next to Erica. Smile.
Now
again, one last
time.
All right. Isaiah, go.
Let's snap that picture. Wave something.
Hi.
Are we all set? Everybody here?
Yep. No, Frank Jay's not here, but you know.
Ah. All right, closer. One, two, three. Two.
Looks like going to a funeral.
There we go. All right. Everybody smile here.
Why'd you?
Dan.
Dan.
My, that's nice.
Got it.
Janis. Damn.
One more.
Show some white teeth. There you
got
go.
Got a reset. All right, everybody smile here.
Smile here. I did.
I got to go back to school. Heidi.
By the way. You want to go up for a picture?
Yeah, you might get a
picture. Smile.
Smile. Smile. Oh. Smile.
All right, everybody up here. Deidre, up here. Everybody. Now, let's get one more just in case. Let it reset. Hold on. I know I'm getting nervous. Stay up. Stay up. Look here. Now I get a little closer. One, two. One
that's
more.
Earlier.
Oh, now you're seeing.
Yes.
That looks good.
How about if we do the uncle and the bride together,
yep.
And you and your mom?
Yeah.
Okay.
And then me and Jan and we're done.
Stretch them out.
Why are you sitting there?
Smile. That's cute.
Did you ever get it?
I got it.
Bad pride.
One more.
You want her to look straight at you?
I want her to look right at me directly. One more.
camera goes dead. And I want everybody else to stop taking.
I am not.
Let me take one off.
You
can get the
flowers.
All right.
Can we get Jay in here?
Now stay right there, Jay.
They left.
They went over the reception.
Stay right there, Jay. Stay right
there. Okay. Ready? One more. Let it reset. Battery going.
Is his ring on there, too?
Yes.
Oh, I can't see it. Oh, there it is. I did a good job on your nail, girl.
Okay.
Only the sun came
we're done.
Yeah, I heard about that sound, but I heard her.
Congratulations. I don't know if anybody has congratulated you yet. Have they?
Thank you. Yeah, they have.
Oh, I want to be the first.
You're late.
Yep. Hitting the bottle already, huh? See what marriage does to you? Makes
oh,
you a drink.
I could be walking with two caps. No
matter
what.
There.
I cried.
Hard,
hey.
Yeah,
when
you
guys don't get drunk, no.
Do that again. Do it again.
Can you drink it?
Got my shot.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to introduce the people that have been at the wedding today.
Want some?
Oh, yeah.
Here is mother of groom.
Should be all right.
Irie Rumsey. Uncle of the bride, Jim Sturgis. Flower girls, Desiree Buckley.
Yeah.
A miracle Buckley started by Kate Buchanan.
Yay.
Kate Buchanan started by Kendrick Buchanan. Kendrick Buchanan started by Ken Travis. Heidi Sixter, escorted by the Dan Buchanan. Commission of Honor, Carrie Buckley. Escorted by Best Man, Mike Buchanan. And introduced for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Buchanan. Congratulations on wedding day! Everybody drink!
Pretty good, Mr. MC.
Good
congratulations, you two.
Thank you.
Flies.
You can call me, I'm a dear. party. Maybe it's the bridegroom party. They can eat now. Just help yourself and get something to eat and sit down and chill out and have a good time.
Thank you.
Hey everybody, we're going to make a toast for the bride and groom for the day that got married.
As opposed to the bride and groom that got divorced.
Oh, okay. Cool.
Yeah, they got married today, I guess, right?
Yeah. All right. Just for today, right? Just kidding, folks. Is that it?
That's it.
That's it.
Yeah.
Everybody drink.
Tell him
Rich likes it. Short and sweet. He's done.
I quit my question is, how would you know?
You told me.
Here you go. Okay, next, the bride and groom. They're gonna dance. And holding it tight. Emotional.
That's the way.
Did you shave?
I haven't got that off.
Double. Double.
Damn, why'd you do that?
Double.
Here I go.
Oh, yeah.
That's for 1 year from right now.
Let's see how long that lasts.